Planet Rock. It's backstage at Ramblin Man Fair with Alex and Jack from Tax the Heat. Afternoon, gents.
Hey, Wyatt.
Afternoon.
So another festival, another appearance. You are fast becoming veterans of the UK festival scene.
I'll take that.
Yeah.
It's nice to be here. This is a new one for us.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's great to be here.
I was going to sort of allude to that. When you're doing festivals, and I know as radio people, when you're interviewing bands, because radio people, for want of a better phrase, get to see more of the environment, where you are. But then when you look at it from the other side, a band playing, again, it's just a stage with people.
Sure. It's a stage that is a hell of a lot more rushed to get onto yeah. than the other stages that you play. But yeah, I mean, there's definitely a certain vibe to a festival crowd that you don't get at a normal gig.
Because you've done plenty of festivals around the UK. Do you, even at this embryonic stage of your careers, get to take it in and think, wow, this is Calling Festival, this is, wow, London in summer. We, you know, this is Ramblin Man Fair, Blackstone, Cherry Whitesnake played it, or is it a bit, it's a gig, let's go.
A little bit of both, really.
Yeah,
I think.
I'd say so. A little bit of both. It's nice to see lots of people.
Yeah.
We turned up with the Gravel Tones playing in the background as we got here today, which was nice.
That is the thing. You kind of bump into loads of people you keep seeing.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's really good, you know, because you kind of get sick of each other.
But then there's a few people you want to see, you don't see them at all, but you'll see the same faces like 10 times.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Oh, we get to see some of the bands, though, and you get to go and check out bands that you wouldn't usually get to check out and stuff. So, yeah, it's just a great thing to be a part of when you come, especially something like this with great bands playing. It's really cool to be a part of.
So despite the fact it feels like you've been around a long time, you're still in the very early stages, the early cycle of the debut album.
Yeah. We're in that, yeah.
Yeah, you're in that. It's quite an early stage. You've been on the scene for 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
The album, last time I spoke to you, it was coming out. It seems to take a dog's age to get here through no one's fault, just the production line.
Yeah.
And now you are in the mix, for want of a better phrase. How are you finding the process? Because it's your first time with an album.
It's great. And it's funny because, like, I mean, I've always bought albums by bands, and I still do a lot. But obviously, there's a whole new generation coming through who are maybe just picking out songs and streaming stuff, and you know what I mean. So I wasn't sure what it would be like releasing an album in this day and age, because that's always been the thing that you have to do: release an album. That's what I would have always loved to have done. But it has. Everybody sees it as now it's like this real thing. They've got an album out. Wow, this is really started now, which is great that it's still like that, because I mean, it's great to have that marker in time. Fed to the Lions came out this year. That's where we were at that point. And we'll keep going with it.
And no one can take that from you. It's there in the archive.
Yeah.
Individually or collectively, what is the one, if there is only one thing, the real eye-opener? Since you brought the album out and you've started the cycle of being a real professional outfit with already the beginning of a back catalogue, is there anything that's happened, be it the album-wise or live-wise, thinking, I didn't expect that to happen once the album came out. I didn't realise this was the way it works. Whether it be people talk to you differently, whether your schedule gets very busy, whether the phone is ringing a lot more.
It just does seem to step up everything that you do when you bring the album out. I think we definitely felt that. But I don't know, I think that was something that we were prepared for. We want to get out there, play as many shows, play whatever shows we can do to as many people that will come and see us. And so I think we've just been prepared to go along with that. So for us, I think it's felt quite natural, but we've definitely seen the step up in terms of everything that happens now since the album's
one weird thing, actually. This isn't a big thing at all, but one weird, I mean, I've played in bands for years, been releasing music for years, slogging it, and been doing that. And then when this album came out and it's like properly in the shops and all over the place, like loads of people from school start messaging me. It's really weird.
Well done.
Where were you 10 years ago?
I found out when I started work at Planet Rock, people I went to school with, I've just listened to you on the radio. It's funny, you didn't listen to me when I was in the class next to you. Or they'll send you pictures of you. Look what I've just seen in HMV. Or on Amazon Prime or whatever.
Yeah, totally.
It's funny.
And one last thing, this is more an observation than a question. You're one of the few bands that would be affected to the negative by hot weather at an outdoor gig because of the clothes. You can't do an Airborne. You can't do a Joel O'Keefe and get your kit off. That's it.
We learned that pretty early on. We did a tour with Black Star Riders, and it was like a heat wave, And that was our first proper, one of our first tours. And yeah, it was so hot. It was so hot. So we've adjusted it a little bit.
So you got, you wear an inch bigger collar shirt. So.
Well, what it is like we don't turn around. So the front half is suit, completely naked. But it's just string.
So you,
we can't move.
You walk on sideways. You shuffle on. Sideways.
Yeah. We rely.
It's your naked bum.
We rely on the crowd a lot. Yeah. We can't move. We're just there. Yeah.
Stationary.
Yeah. It's clever.
It's doing crab walks onto a stage. That's
right.
That's a line dance in the making right there.
Well, that's it. That's the future.
Yeah. Can't wait to see that. Been done on YouTube.
Don't be
videos.
On the stage, though. You don't want to see it from that side.
No, no.
In yeah.
The imagery that's going through here.
Yeah.
Well, Jack and Alex, it's been a pleasure as always. Have a great performance.
Thanks.
And good luck with the rest of the album cycle and for many years beyond.
Thank you very much. Cheers.